not only for a GPX file of Quazy Rides, but for all GPX files. Hi, I'm Muriel and welcome to another Quazy Ride. And in this video, I'm going to show you how I use a GPX file on my Garmin Basecamp for my Garmin device, this Zumo. Together with Johan, I have been road tripping through Europe, but also USA and South Africa for over 20 years. And we started with written directions in a little roller on the handlebars. But ever since 2007, we have been using a sat-nav, not to have the sat-nav determine which route we would be taking, but to have the sat-nav help us to follow the route that we prepared using an old-fashioned map. As we want to share all our experience and fun on road tripping with Quazy Rides, I will now show you how I use Garmin Basecamp to import GPX files on my device, my Garmin Zumo. And I am sure that if you're using another device, it will work in a similar way. But if you still have questions on the other device, please contact us, telling us what device you are using, and maybe I can look into that later. With the Quazy Rides online planning tool, you can plan your own road trip in just a few clicks using the tools that we have available. In our video, how to use the contents of your order, we have explained what the contents of your Quazy Rides road trip are and how you can use them on our website. If you have placed an order through our website and you haven't watched that video yet, please make sure that you watch that video too. With an order on the Quazy Rides website, you will have the opportunity to download the GPX files and then you have to save them somewhere. Okay, so you open your Garmin Basecamp. And I want to show you that I've always downloaded the maps to my computer as well. You can use the maps on your device, but then you have to plug in your device every time you want to use Basecamp and it will slow it down. So I always use this one. I do always check that I have the same map on my computer and on my device, of course. Okay, on the upper left corner, you will see my collection, well, your collection. And I've already made a backup of 2021 routes, but I still need them, so they're still here. But I try to keep this as clean as possible so I can find my routes quickly. To use GPX files, I always make a separate new list folder per like road trip or weekend or what have you you want to be going on. So I do a right click and make a new list folder. And let's call this one how to video. In that folder, I then want to make a new list. And I am calling this chocolate and beer, as I am going to import the chocolate and beer rides here. I always make or import the routes that I want to upload in one go in this one list. Okay, to import our ride one and two of the chocolate and beer tour, for this example, I select the new list I just made, chocolate and beer, and go to File, Import into Chocolate and Beer. And I have saved the chocolate and beer one and two on my desktop. So I'll just open them. And voila. So in the left corner, you will find first all the points of interest, then the routes, and then the tracks of these two GPX files I've just imported. I prefer to use routes, as I always check my routes in Garmin Basecamp, but Some people prefer to use tracks because a track does give the least deviation from the, well, intended route. The downside of using tracks is that you will not get notifications when you are approaching a point of interest in your route. Therefore, in a Quazy Rides GPX file, you will always get, besides the full route, tracks per part. So going from one point of interest to the next point of interest, and you will also receive the total track. So you can use whatever you prefer. To have all the information of the contents of this list in the middle of your screen, just double click the list. It zooms in. Okay, don't worry if you will see like straight lines going from point to point, because then you might have to recalculate first. And you can do that by opening your route. You can do that by double clicking. And then you will get all the information in the screen of this route. To make sure that your route is following the roads, you might have to change this setting to just motorcycling. And then it will start recalculating. You won't see it because it's in my second screen. Or you can recalculate manually if you're already in the right setting, because then the route will be recalculated, but it will be a good route if it has enough waypoints, and then it will take you on the route. Of course, if you would want to, you could make some changes in this route, but we do not recommend you to change anything more than adding your accommodation that you have chosen and booked with a Quazy Rides route. We will show you to add the accommodation in a separate video, and I will link it here as soon as that one is available. Once your routes are final and you want to upload them to your Garmin device, hook up your device. And wait for it to be connected. You see that it will appear in your screen here in the left upper corner. Then use this icon, send new list to device, select your device and click OK. Just wait for the route to be downloaded to your device. And once it's green, it's downloaded and you can disconnect your device, and that's it. We will also be showing you what to do on your Garmin device in a separate video, but this all works for the GPX file you have downloaded from your Quazy Rides account, but also for other GPX files that you have received. I do hope this all made sense and that it will help you to get on your way. If it did, please hit that like button and subscribe to our channel. And if you want to know how our Quazy Rides planning tool works, you can watch that video in the middle of your screen.